This is Dr. Masters thanking you for clicking on to today's mini consultation. A person's choices of goals as they go through life can, as I'm sure you'll agree, make all the difference in the world as to whether they live a life that has a lasting fulfillment and happiness in it. In establishing goals, the vast majority of people will be more inclined to think of goals such as being successful, having a family and or children, having love in their life, having a sufficient education, expressing in the creative arts, and other worldly goals. All those goals are fine. But more or all can produce lasting happiness or fulfillment unless the choice of any of these goals were why God gave you life, this lifetime, to live. In ultimate reality, only goals chosen that are in line with what God's goals are for your life to experience will give a person lasting happiness and fulfillment. All other achievement of goals, as far as any type of happiness and fulfillment, are really more temporary happiness and fulfillment. This is why those who have reached a higher state of spiritual awareness and consciousness know that the first and ultimate goal of life is to find God's presence within themselves, and in so doing, find what God's will is for their lives, and thus to have one goal or many goals as a person goes through life that are in attunement and alignment with God's will for this lifetime. With this in your thoughts, let us turn inward. I turn inward to the very center and nucleus of my mind, that Christ mind conscious point of contact where my soul is in an eternal state of oneness with the mind and spirit of God. Here in the light of higher awareness within myself, let me recognize that unless the goals that I set for myself are in attunement and alignment with what God's goals are for me to achieve in this life, that I will not achieve any lasting fulfillment and lasting happiness. Therefore, I have to, as my first ultimate goal in life, find out what God's will is for my life. Whether I'm 20 years old and just starting out, or whether I'm along in years, what is God's ultimate will for my life? And let that ultimate will, that is God's, set the goals for me. For if God sets the goals, I will achieve those goals and find lasting fulfillment and happiness. To do this, I have to get that which creates lesser goals away from my consciousness and ruling my consciousness. Therefore, each and every day, I set aside my personal ego and its will and give it up to God's presence within me and God's will for my life. I empower this process of inner intuitive communication between my conscious awareness and God's presence by meditating each day on God's presence, achieving a greater linkage, as it were, between God's presence at the center of my mind and my surface awareness, that my surface awareness may be guided by God's goals for me in this life, which is God's will for me in this life. For this realization of life's ultimate goal, achieving God's will for my life and letting it be lived through me, I give thanks, I let it be so, and so it is. A reminder to watch our current complimentary weekly video broadcast available to you 24/7 on universityonline.tv. And let others know about our current complimentary weekly videos and, of course, the daily mini consultations. Refer to universityonline.tv for the subject matter of each week's weekly videos containing deep spiritual insights, realities, and spiritual self-help of a higher nature. And also be aware that universityonline.tv has mobile versions designed for smaller screens of tablets, smartphones, netbooks, and other handheld devices. So whether you're at your computer at home or wherever you are, we can be there with you. Thank you for joining with me today, and be certain to click on again tomorrow for a new mini consultation. In the interim, may God bless you and those you love today and this eternal moment of always.